Welcome, Diploma 2 students. I think last time we derived the formula of getting the steady state error, and in this lesson we said that we'll come and tackle a question regarding the topic of errors. So this is the first example you've been taught. The open loop transfer function of a unit feedback is given by G of S 50 all over 1 plus 0.15 into brackets multiplied by 10 plus s into brackets. So this is the open loop transfer function. So open loop transfer function is given by, we have 50 all over 1 plus 0.15 10 plus s. So this is the open loop transfer function. We can draw the block diagram of the open loop transfer function with our feedback, and this is how we shall draw it. We have the summing point. You know that the reference feedback will be getting with a positive, and the feedback will be a negative. So this is our plant G. So this is the open loop transfer function, which is 50 all over 1 plus 0.15 10 plus S. Then our output is C of S, and the feedback, you know that you can see for this case you have not been given the feedback, so the feedback is automatically 1. This is your R of S, then 1 is your feedback. So this is the open loop transfer function. So you've been told to find the static error coefficients of Kp, Kv, and Aka. So for instance, you know that Kp represents the static ramp coefficient error. You know that Kv represents the static this one is a unit step this one is static ramp coefficient error. Then the other one is Ka. Ka represents the parabolic coefficient error. So this is what you've been told to find: the Kp, Kv, and Ka. So let's begin with the Kp. Kp is given by your limit s to 0 g of s h of s, and for this case you've been given the g, which is your plant, and the feedback is h of s, which is 1. So this is how you will go about it. So Kp is equals to limit, you limit s to 0, your g is 50 all over 1 plus 0.15 10 plus s, then your feedback is always this one, so it is not making any change. So for instance, this is the formula for getting Kp. You get it by, you limit S to 0, 50 all over 1 plus 0.5 multiplied by 10S. When you've been told to limit S towards 0, wherever you have S, you will replace it with 0. So our Kp is equal to limit S 0, 50 all over 1 plus 0.15 multiplied by 10 plus 0. So that is how it will look like. So you will get, if you have limited S to 0, you will get 50. Wherever you have S, you replace with 0. So it will be all over 1 plus 0.15 multiplied by 10. You can also solve this one further by opening up the brackets. So you'll get limit S to 0, 50 all over 10 plus 0.15 times 10, you get 1.5. So here you will get 50 all over 11.5. 50 divided by 11.5, you get 11.5. You will get 4.3478. So that is the answer after we have calculated the Kp. Let's go to the second one, which is Kv. Kv now, Kv given by, you limit S to 0. Now you insert, you have an S here, you have an S there, so you get limit S to 0, S, G of S, H of S. So you can see for the Kv, you have got an S here, before you get this is the open loop transfer function, then you multiply it with an S. So you will get S. You have your G. Your G is 50. 50 all over 1 plus 0.15 multiplied by 10 plus S. That is what you have. Then from there you have been told to limit S to 0. When you limit S to 0, you will get Kv is equals to limit. After you have limited to 0, you will get, this one will be 0. Sorry, this one will be 0. 0 multiplied by 50 all over 1 plus 0.15, 10 plus 0. So Kv is equals to limit S to 0, this one will be 0 all over, this is 10, we got 11.5, and I know any number that you divide it with. Now let's proceed. You can see there was an error that I had meant. When you multiply, when you reduce everything to 0 and you multiply with 0, automatically here you will get a 0. Let's move to the third one, which is Ka. Ka, you get it by, you limit everything to 0. Now S will be squared for Ka. G of S, H of S. So for this case, you have been given your g, and you know that your h is 1. Since we said that if you have not been given the value of h, automatically it becomes 1. So Ka is equals your limit s to 0, s squared, your g, it is 50, all over 1 plus 0.15. You have now 1 plus 0.15, you multiply it with 10 plus s. After you have limited everything to 0, you multiply the whole of this with 0, you will get Ka is equals to 0. And that is how you get the values of Kp, Kv, and Ka in determining the error coefficients of a value. So thank you so much. Next lesson, we will solve another problem. And after that, I will give you a past paper. You solve a question paper, a question in that past paper. Thank you so much.